Before we get to dish on some celebrity news, Big Al from V101.1 is joining us to talk about the hottest headlines. And boy, Big Al, was this a week.
Man, I'm telling you, it's been crazy out there.
It's crazy. All right, we're going to get to some real craziness in a minute, but a recently discovered beetle species is being named after one of Hollywood's famous actors. And is it like a womanizer bug or something like that?
I guess so. I'm trying to research this. I got my glasses on because I'm trying to read the name of the actual beetle. But it was discovered in Malaysia by a waterfall, and it's called the Grovanilius Leonardo DiCaprioi. I hope I said that thing right. But it's a very interesting beetle. I'm seeing this. It's actually discovered by a tour company who does nature tours across in different countries, and they discovered it. It's a pretty distinct beetle, I'll just say that.
It does. It little antennas on the front end of it kind of looks like a Leonardo stash. So I'll take it. He probably has a lot of lady friends too. All right, so Kanye West had quite the week. We saw him explode on TMZ Live, and he's also dropping some new music for this whole big album thing he's doing, but he's in Wyoming. What is going on with Kanye West?
I'm right there with you, Martina. No one knows what the heck's going on with Kanye West. He's not taking his meds, or he's thinking a different train of thought, but he's going back to, he has a house in Wyoming. It's literally built on a mountaintop, okay? I don't know how he got this house, but that's where he's staying and making his new music, and he flies in different artists that's going to do features on his album to record songs. And by the way, when you talk about the TMZ interview, he's saying, look, I'm glad that happened. He actually liked the interview and all the drama that caused, because he got people to think, and that's what his ultimate goal. I'm just thinking, look, go to the mountaintop, take your medication, Kanye, make some good music, and keep it moving. Stop with all this other madness. Come on, man.
Just stick to art, I guess. All right, so we're getting this really cool opportunity now that the Star Wars movie is coming out, the Han Solo one, where we get to tour the Millennial Falcon with Donald Glover, of all people.
Yes, Donald Glover, a.k.a. Childish Gambino.
Yes.
He's acting, he does music. He's going to be the young Lando Calrissian in the new Star Wars movie, Solo, A Star Wars Story, coming out on Memorial Day weekend, I believe. And you know what? It's a really cool thing to see. In the beginning, the previous Star Wars movies, the Millennium Falcon was a hoopty, it was a hunk of junk. And this one is how he first discovered the Millennium Falcon. It is brand new, new compartments, new everything. It is really cool. I'm ready to see this movie. I am so ready to see Solo, A Star Wars Story.
Me too. I'm so excited for that as well. And I did not know, because yeah, in all the Star Wars movies, Millennial Falcon is kind of a dump. But this one had like a great bed, has a big walk-in closet. It's pretty cool.
It's got the new Millennium Falcon smell.
Yes, it does. Brand new smell. Thank you so much, Big Al. I really appreciate you joining us today. Paul, I wonder what the Millennial Falcon smells like. What does a new spaceship smell like?
Downtown Woodland. Gonna